Morning students, in last class we studied about the degree system and gradient system. We made also some questions today and also we made 5 examples. Today we'll start exercise 3.1 and I'll do definitely some important question. Hope you have completed this exercise from your side. Exercise 3.1. First question, find the radian measurement. Question says, find the radian measurement. And we have a 4 question in that. So I especially am telling you question number 2. Minus 47 degree and 30 minutes. So let me speak frankly that if you want the radian measurement, first you have to convert that minute or something like in complete degree. So how we can convert in complete degree? That's very easy. I taught you that it is minus, it is 47 degree plus 30 minute. That's simple. Even what I made here, only I took out minus just outside the bracket. I won't do work on that. Minus, this is 47 already degree. This is 30 minute. Definitely, I'll divide by 60. So, on dividing by 60, it automatically gets its degree. Now, minus 47 degree, this by cancellation, 1 by 2 will come. Degree. And then after, I'll combine these two, 47 and half, because it is plus sign. I've made a complete degree. And then after, I'll take an LCM. Sorry, it's a simple, it's a mixed fraction. I'll convert in a fraction. This whole is going to be 95 by 2 degree. So this is the question, and now we have changed in complete degree. Now it's time to go on the radian measurement. So how to turn the radian measurement? It's very simple. 95 upon 2, it was a degree. Now I'll multiply by pi by 180 and it is now radian. Radian also can be called as C. Also can be called, it's only C, right? C only there at the power, it is called a radian. And then just by cancellation, I cancel by 5. It gonna be 19 and it is 36. I'll cancel by 5. 36 by 180 and 19 plus 95. So I cancel by 5 and in last I would write 19 pi upon 72. This is radian and this is answer. 19 and 72. I think it is not cancelled. No matter at all. So 19 pi by 72, now it is not being simplified more. So it is your answer. If you want to put the value of pi 22 by 7, you can, but no matter at all. If you'll admit me, I just want to give you one advice. Whenever you want answer in radian, leave your answer in pi. So it is good to leave your answer in pi when you want your answer in radian. So this is your answer. Okay. So hope this you have got very easily. Now I'll go on next. I have fifth, suppose fourth one I'm telling you. It's a 520 degree. So I don't think it's a trouble because it is already a complete degree and we want to turn in radian. So in short trick I taught you, just multiply by pi by 180, it is automatically have turned in radian. Now you can cancel and get your answer. Just very formal, 0 and 0 cancel. 52 and 18 cancel by 2, so 26 and 9 and pi, it is your answer. So I don't want to do any further work after that. Extreme only you can do that. You can put pi is equal to 22 by 7, but further you don't have any way to solve. So I think it is better to leave your answer in the form of pi. So hope you have got. Now you can do all the rest questions. The next question is, Find the degree measurement. This is question number 2. Find the degree measurement. So how to turn to degree measurement? Look at. We have a 4 question. So I am taking question 2 and question number 4. Question 2 says, it is minus 4 and it is radian. And we want its degree answer. So how to turn in degree, I taught. We just multiply by 180 upon pi. And I want to keep minus outside. And this is going to be now degree. This is first step. Now I'll do some changes. 4, it's going to be 720 upon, this is 22 by 7. And one thing we should remember, that whenever we want answer in degree, we just have to convert that in minute and second, where it is possible. Like, I'll do now 720 into 7 upon 22 degree, then it is a minus sign. And after cancellation, I'll get 360 into 7 upon 11, I cancel by 2. Further, it is not possible. So I'll write only minus of, I'll multiply these two. Is 2520 upon 11, it is degree. It is not called an answer. It is a fraction degree. It's our duty to convert that in minute and second also. So, I'll divide and you know the method. I'll divide. And I'll turn in first the mixed fraction. And then slowly I will go in minute and second. So it is like after division, 11 2s are 22, 3, 11 2s are 22, 10, 11 9s are, yes, it is 229 whole 1 by 11 degree. Then I'll write 229 plus 1 by 11 degree. Then I'll write 229 degree and 1 by 11 degree. Then I will turn that degree in minute by multiplying 60, it is automatically gonna minutes. After it, you know the procedure. I'll 60 upon 11 gonna. So I'll divide and again turn in mixed fraction. 11 5s are 55. It's very simple term. It is a minute. Now I'll write 229 degree and 5 minute, and directly I'm breaking it now. Plus 5 by 11 minute. So this is 229 complete degree, 5 minute you have done, and now I'll again multiply by 60 and turn that in a second. So it's my final procedure, because after the second we don't have any more units. So it is 300 upon 11, this is second, and after division I'll find my answer in approximation. This is 27.2 approximately on dividing. Yes, it is 27.2 approximately, and final answer will be left like minus 229 degree, 5 minute, 27.2 second. It is the complete degree answer of this particular minus 4 radian. So this is one of the easiest method ever. Even it was a simple number like 11 by 16, very first question we have, and it will follow the same method. Honestly, I would speak one thing, that if you can see question number 3rd and question number 4 of the second question, it gonna be so easy. Why? Because pi is there. So let me explain that in this area, in 2 step, I can tell you question number 3rd and 4th. Even I'm telling you one only. 4th, suppose I'm telling you. 4th one. It is 7 pi by 6 radian. You want its a degree answer. And it is very easy to you. You will write only 180 by pi. And it is a degree. Now you have turned it. Pi and pi will cancel this in this kind of question, whenever pi is available in a question. So pi and pi automatically will cancel, and the rest will be 7 by 6 into 180. And again, treasure thing is, these can cancel. So 6 and this will cancel by 30, and 30 sevens are 210 degree. You have got 7 pi by 6 value. So it's very easy for one and all. If it's supposed to not canceling, suppose it is to be 5 here, you have to do the same method. Like 7 into 80, 180 will be something 126 or 1260. And upon 6, then you have to, upon suppose 5 is coming, you have to divide and do the same method. When it is easily cancelling, okay, find the answer in easy way. But it is not easily cancelling, you have to turn in degree and minute also. Sorry, degree, minute and second also. Okay, so I just want to close this question here. Now I will take some word problem. So look at the word problem, what it says. Not all, but some question I will tell you. What I am looking, question number third to tell you. Question third says, a wheel makes 360 revolution in 1 minute. Through how many radians does it cover in 1 second? So what is the meaning of question? That wheel is making 360 revolution in 1 minute. And question asking in 1 second, that particular wheel makes what radian at the center? Let me speak something. Question says, in 1 minute, the wheel moves 360 revolution. So I'll write here, given that since in, it's given that in 1 minute, a wheel revolves 360 revolution. This sentence I write in different way. In 1 minute, I write, or in 60 seconds, because 1 minute and 60 seconds are same. In 60 seconds, it revolves 360 revolution. It moves 360 revolution. In 60 seconds, it makes 360 revolution. So, in 1 second, it completes 360 upon 60 revolution, meaning 6 revolution. So, very simple thing you have got. Can you think about a wheel? This is wheel. Question was asking in 1 minute, it is making 360 revolution. So I ask you that in 1 second, how many revolution it will make? Definitely it is 6 coming. Why? In 60 second, the total number of revolution was 60, 360. So in 1 second, you just have to divide and get answer. It is not complete your answer. It is only telling that in 1 second, it is rounding 6 time. It is rounding 6 time. And question asking that in 1 second, wheel moves how many radians? Very interesting question it is. I simply ask you one thing, that this is a wheel. In one revolution, what centered angle will be formed? What centered angle will be formed? So definitely in one revolution, 360 degree will be formed at the center. So how many revolution it is being here? 6 revolution in 1 second. Question was asking that in 1 second, what radian it will make on a center? So I will say that in one revolution, since wheel is making 360 degree on the center, so in 6 revolution, it will make 360 into 6 degree on the center. So I just want to speak something more special, that 360 degree equal to 2 pi radian. And if you're not comfortable, no matter at all, I will write some special sentence. Since in one revolution, the centered angle at wheel, centered angle is equal to 360 degree. It is in degree. It is in degree. And if you will go, I just want to tell you that 360 degree meaning how many radian? How many radian? I just want to write my answer in radian, because question asking radian. So it's very interesting that you should remember that 360 degree equal to how many radian? So you turn in radian. You turn in radian, rough section. So it is 2. So 2 pi radian. So keep remember in the mind that 360 degree equal to 2 pi radian. Meaning, instead of that, I also can write 2 pi radian because our answer is in the form of radian. So it's very interesting now. In one revolution, the centered angle equal to 2 pi radian. So in 6 revolution, why 6 revolution? Because question was asking in 1 second. In 1 second, how many revolution completed? 6 revolution. So in 6 revolution, what centered angle will be? Central angle will be 2 pi into 6, meaning answer will be 12 pi radian. In radian we have got the answer. So in 12 pi radian will be the centered angle in 6 revolutions. Very interesting it is, and very simple also. So hope you have got till now. Question was asking, so yes, we give the answer. Now the next thing is, question is which I want to tell you. Fifth one. Question says, in a circle of diameter 40, so its diameter is 40, this is suppose center O and AB is a diameter, so AB equal to 40. The length of chord is 20. The length of chord, suppose it is a chord, CD is a chord, is a 20. It is a 20. Now again, what question says? Find the length of the minor arc of the chord. Minor arc of the chord. Just want to speak something that we want to find that only. This is the minor arc. Suppose I am not making this one. Suppose I am not making this one. And I just want to make O as a center. CD is a chord of length 20 cm. Question is asking, while making the chord, two arcs created. It is a minor arc, it is a major arc. Question says, find the length of the minor arc made by the chord CD. So we just want to find that CD chord, the measurement of that arc, measurement of the arc CD, and want to speak something when you will join that in that. It is a pleasure that this particular measurement of the arc equal to centered angle. One should know, it is not a new thing, already have read in class 10th, that measurement of an arc actually in degree or in radian. Now radian is a new word for you. So in degree or radian, whatever question asks in a length of minor arc of the chord, we just want that length of chord we told here. What says again? In a circle of diameter 40, the diameter of the circle is 40, the length of the chord is 20, find the length of minor arc of that only arc we won't find out. That only CD we just want. And how, what the CD can be find out just because of that, it is equal to this degree. So we just have to find the value of this one. Okay, and then after we can find the length of the arc. Questions? Answer is in form of a degree or in centimeter, meter, something. I just look and then I tell you that what to find out. It's in a word, it is a bit confusion. That's why I want to see the answer. The answer of this fifth question is 20 pi by 3. So question is actually the sentence or the language of the question is a bit wrong. Question was asked, find the length of minor arc. Question was asking the length of the minor arc, but the answer is given in degree or radian. It means that 20 pi something it is given. So give it a try. We will find the length of the CD. Let's see what will come. First, I want to speak something. We are told to find the length of this arc. Length CD. We want to find the length CD. Okay, first I'll find that only angle. This is called a centered angle. And interesting, I say something. It's given that diameter of the circle is 40 centimeter, yes? So radius will be 20 centimeter. And do you think that is a radius? 20 in 20, it is. And chord CD, the length of the chord CD is again 20 centimeters. So it is a 20 centimeter already given. It is 20 centimeter. So one thing which is in our favor, that this and this all are equal. So this is gonna be equilateral triangle, and this is gonna be angle 60 degree. So triangle OCD will be an equilateral triangle. So centered angle COD gonna be 60 degree. So this angle you have got now. Now we want to find the length of the chord. The length of the chord we are told to find out. So I just have taught you the concept. You remember that this is L, this is theta, this is radius, and theta degree equal to L upon R radian. You remember this formula. Use here everything you are having here as you compare. Don't make this, and I just want to continue after that. Let theta is equal to 60 degree, which is a centered angle. Look at centered angle, and the radius is equal to 20. It's the radius equal to 20. It is already given, and as per the figure, this is the length of arc, which is L, which you have to find out. Now I'll go with the formula. We know that theta degree equal to L upon R radian. So theta degree was 60 degree. L meaning length of arc. Radian is equal to, radius equal to 20, and it is a radian. And I taught you that this is degree and this is radian. It cannot be compared. So first I'll turn to 60 degree in radian. By 60 into pi by 180, this is gonna be radian. L upon 20, it is again radian. Now I'll cancel and I'll write pi by, this is gonna be 3. Radian I'm not writing, L upon 20. Both radian can compare, and I simplified, and then 20 I'll transfer here. So 20 pi by 3 is equal to L in centimeter is the answer. 20 pi by 3 in centimeter. So I saw the answer just because of confusion, that whether this asked in a degree measurement or something like that. Sometime in degree measurement it is equal to 60. Let me speak something, but length is not in degree. Length always come in a centimeter or meter. So length was asked, so that we got an answer. So by using this formula, we have got the answer. You don't need to make this picture, because it is just continuing. And what is the important thing in that? The 40 was diameter. So these two will be radius 20, 20. Length of chord is again 20. So by these three, we can find 60 degree centered angle, which is called theta. And radius equal to 20, length of arc L, we have to find out. By this method, we can easily find out. Okay, now this was the question. Fifth, further, question number 6 already I have taught in example, so it's your job, not mine. And question number 7 is again very easy. Question 7 says, find the angle in radian through which a pendulum swings if its length is 75 cm and the tip describe an arc of length. Three questions are given. So I'm just making a pendulum like that, and the length of pendulum 75 centimeter, and the length of arc is given. Find the angle in radian. We are actually, what we are asked, this angle we want to find out, and tip describe an arc of length 15, 10 and 21 centimeter. Suppose I'm trying to do 21 centimeter. Question says, the length of the arc is 21 centimeter, formed by the 75 centimeter long pendulum, and we want to find the angle in radian. So definitely initially I'll write this is theta, and we know that by figure that L equal to 21 centimeter, radius equal to 75 centimeter, and we know that theta degree equal to L upon R radian. So answer will be theta degree equal to L, 21 upon 75 radian. So answer is theta equal to, this is cancelling by 3. So it is 7 by 25 radian. This is the answer, because we are told the answer in the radian. So whatever theta degree was in the form of 7 by 25 radian. We don't have to convert anything, because we are told the answer. Find the answer in the radian, and we have got. So this is first exercise from my side. So from tomorrow I'll tell you what is one of the important lecture it will be. So please join tomorrow and see the tomorrow's lecture also. Thank you.